Hi children, good morning. How are you? Hope you are fine. I am Kamala Kumari, your science teacher. We are giving you online classes regularly. Our next lesson, what is it children? It is animals and their food. Yes, see the picture. All the animals, they are in search of food. Animals and their food. Do you have pet animals like dog, cat, or any birds, rabbits? And did you observe how they eat? Did you take care of your pet animals? And anytime did you observe their eating habits? What do they eat? How do they eat? Depending upon the food habits, animals are divided into three types. So, what are they? Let us learn in this lesson. First one, herbivores. Second one, carnivores. Third one, omnivores. So, these are herbivores. Animals that depend on only on plants for their food, they are called as herbivorous animals. So they eat plant and plant products. Can you see the picture, children? So these are buffalo. It eats grass and fodder. Sheep eats grass. Donkey, grass. Camel, leaves and grass. Can you see the pig? Pig also, it eats grass, fruits and vegetables. What is this, children? Can you see? So our next one is carnivores. Animals that depend only on animals for their food are called carnivorous animals. So these animals eat other animals as their food. See the picture, tiger, leopard, puma, snow leopard, polar bear, seal, all are carnivores, isn't it? Our next one is, third one is omnivores. Animals that depend on both plants and animals for their food. This is known as omnivores. You can see human beings, chimpanzee, dog, rat, civet, and all this tiny anteater, these are all rat, dog, monkey, bear. These eat both plants and animals. These are omnivorous animals. Frugivorous animals. What are frugivorous animals? Animals that feed on raw fruits. Succulent fruits like vegetables, roots, shoots, nuts, and seeds are called frugivorous animals. These can be any type of herbivore or omnivore where fruit is preferred food type. 20% of all mammalian herbivores, they eat fruits. They come under frugivorous animals. You can see the picture, children. These are frugivorous animals. Yes, squirrel, these all are. Okay, next. How do animals eat their food? Animals also depend on different sources for their food. Most animals feed regularly. But first, they must trace out the food. Where the food is available. They should trace out. They should search first. To do this, they will use different sense organs like smell, sight, hearing, taste and touch. Many animals have specialized parts of their body such as mouth, hands or feet that help them to collect their food. Pond skaters. This is an insect which feeds on other insects on the water surface. They compared the ripples on the opposite of the pond caused by the legs of the insect struggling to move out. They observed this movement on the water and they catch the small insects. Pond skaters also are also insects, but they eat small insects. So they calculate the distance and set out to grab it. Leech. Can you see the picture, children? What is that picture? Leech. These leeches, they stick onto the skin and suck the blood of cattle as well as human beings. With the help of a specialized structures are present which are called suckers. So with the help of these suckers, they suck the blood of the human beings and cattle. In this way, they catch their food. How do birds get their food? So very interesting to observe about the birds' food. They eat their food with their beaks. Different birds have different beaks. Woodpecker, what does it have? It has a long and strong beak. By using this, it will remove the layers of the bark of the tree. What is the bark of the tree? The outermost layer of the tree is called bark. And eat ants and pests which are lying under the bark. The crane has a long beak to catch fish in water. Can you see the picture, children? Woodpecker and crane? Yes. Look at their beaks. Vultures have strong hooked beaks to tear flesh of animals. Vultures also have sharp claws to tear the flesh. So with the help of beaks and claws, they tear the flesh. Can you see the picture, children? Vulture picture. How strong its beak is. Next, can you see parrot beak? It has a hooked beak to eat fruits and it will crack the nuts also. Hummingbird, see the picture, children. It has a long thin beak. And what does it eat as food? Nectar from the flowers. It will suck the nectar from the flowers. That's why it has long thin beak. And duck, see the duck's beak. They have a teeth, but it is not useful for grinding food. It just acts as a filter and it will catch the fish and all the water it will expel out. That's why its beak will act as a filter. What is this picture, children? Vulture and crow. You can see this. These both are called as natural scavengers. Why they are called natural scavengers, children? They eat waste rotten food materials like dead animals, etc. So they keep our surroundings clean. That's why they are called as scavengers. You can see the picture. Yes. What is this? Frog. Frog, you observe whenever you get a chance, children. How does it get its food? It has a long, sticky tongue. So very interesting to observe this. And it will throw out its sticky tongue whenever it will observe any insect. And that insect gets stuck on the frog's tongue. Then the frog swallows it. In this way, the frog will catch the insects. That's all for today, children. Thank you.